Welcome to ePaathshala lecture series on postgraduate courses. We are discussing about cryptography and network security. In this, now we are going to discuss about RSA crypto system. The objectives are to know about RSA public key crypto system, to understanding RSA algorithm, and also we are going to discuss about security features in RSA. In public key crypto system, where we know there will be two different key, where one is a public key, another one is a private key. So, RSA was proposed in 1977 by Ron L. Revist at Samir and Leonard Adleman at MIT. The best known and widely used public key scheme, it is based on exponentiation in a finite field over integrated modulo a prime. The main patent expired in 2000. So, these three persons were behind this RSA crypto system: Samir, Revist and Adleman. RSA algorithm, where it uses two keys. We already know there will be one public key, another private key. So, here we can able to see that they use letter E to represent the public key and D for the private key. So, in order to generate this information, we have to do further steps involved in encrypting of the particular algorithm. So, E is used for encryption, D is used for decryption. So, these two keys are going to be generated based on the prime numbers. So, before going to discuss about how these E and D are going to be generated, we need to understand the encryption process. If Alice want to send a message to Bob, where he choose a message as M, is need to be encrypted before sending to the Bob. So, I want to generate a ciphertext. So, C is equal to M power E mod N. So, now our algorithm is very simple, and also it is going to be able to understand with a single step. C is equal to, suppose I want to generate a ciphertext C from the message M, what I recovered is E and also N. So, C is equal to M power E mod N, then this ciphertext is recovered by M is equal to C power D mod N. So, now the decryption process. This is an encryption process, this is a decryption process. The decryption process, when Bob receives this C, he should have the D, then only he can able to get back the message M. So, if Bob have D, then the encryption also going to be very simple and easily you can able to understand. That is, M is equal to C power D mod N, C power D mod N. So, I am getting back the original message. How this makes going to be easier? Because the symmetric in modular arithmetic is the reason how these two are going to make this algorithm as more successful. What we can able to understand here is the D and E are symmetric in nature with respect to modulo arithmetic. So, when I am using E, I can able to encrypt. But when I am using D, I can able to get the decrypted message. So, what I can able to understand here is E and D must be symmetric with respect to modular arithmetic. M is equal to C power D mod N, where M power E D, that is I am substituting in the place of C. What is C? C is M power E. So, C is M power E, then the D is given here, So when I am having exponents, it is interchangeable, nothing going to affect my output. So what is happening here? I can get back here as m, that is m power d e mod n. So that is why these two keys are it can able to get off inverse of other, where I can able to get the message. So one can use one key to encrypt a message and other key to decrypt a message. So that is the idea behind your public key crypto system. In public key crypto system, where I use one key for encryption, the other key for decryption. So what I understood from this particular step is E and D are symmetric. E and D are symmetric in modular arithmetic. If both are symmetric, so that I can use one for E for encryption, then D for decryption. The important point we need to remember here is, if Alice want to send a message to Bob, or Bob want to send a message to Alice, these two persons involving in the secure communication must generate two keys instead of one key, what we have discussed in the case of your AES and DES algorithm. These two keys must be, one key must be kept as secret, that is private key. So what Alice will do, Alice will generate E comma D, that is Alice E comma D. Bob also generate E comma D. Then Alice and Bob must keep their D a secret. And if Alice want to get a message from other users, then he need to share the E over the internet, or any particular medium they can able to share the E. So E is public. I'm not worry about E. Whoever want, they can able to get my E, but I should keep my D as secret. So D should not share to anyone. If I share D, then there is no security at all. So one thing we need to come as a point here is, you need to understand here is, E and D are keys, whereas I need to keep the D as secret, E as public. That anyone, if they want to send a message to me, I need to tell them what is my E. I should not share D with anyone. So now we are going to discuss about how this E and D are chosen for a particular user. So remember that each user must have E and D. Each user must generate E and D. They have to keep D as secret, E as public. So for generating E and D, the first thing what I need to do is choose two large prime number at random. So remember that word large prime number, it should be typically of 512 to 2048 bits of size. So it is around, it go for around from start from this 150 digit to 600 digit of decimal. Just think about that much larger prime number. So I need to choose two random large prime number, P and Q. P is one prime number, 2 is another prime number. So I need to choose two different prime numbers of large in size, that is the size of 150 digit to 600 digit, or I can take it as 512 bits to 2048 bits. After, suppose imagine, now this part is only explained with respect to Alice. Okay, if Alice need to choose a key E and D, first thing he has to choose P comma Q. Next step is, this is the second step, compute their modulus. Okay, compute their modulus, because we know very well for the encryption we have n. This n is a multiple of two large prime number. This n is a multiple of two large prime number, that is P and Q. So n is equal to P and Q. And also we need to note this particular process, it's called Euler spy function or Totient function. pi function. So we need to compute phi of n. I think we have discussed this in the case of your number theory. In the number theory, there is one operation called finding a phi function of any particular given number n that is mentioned in this particular point. So I want to find out pi of n. So phi of n is, because n is a multiple of p and q, with the help of that particular Euler's pi function, we can able to compute p minus 1 and q minus 1. When it is a prime number, it's, if I am taking n, it is a multiple of 2 prime numbers, then with respect to the rule 3, I can able to find phi of n, that is p minus 1 and q minus 1. So first thing, I have to choose 2 prime large prime numbers. Second thing, I need to compute the multiplication of this, what is the n, which is used as a modulus. And third step, I need to get the phi function. So these are 3 preliminary works before we start with the choosing of the key. So we need to understand what is a large prime numbers, and also we need to know what is, how we are computing n, and also what is phi of n. Now Alice started to generating the key. Here the E is a randomly generated encryption key, but one condition thing here is E must be chosen in such a way that it should be one lies between 1 and phi of n. That means it must be greater than 1 and less than phi of n. E must be greater than 1, should be in the range 1 to phi of n. So now Alice has chosen the encryption key E. And also the point here we need to consider is, before going to say E is a primary, E is the encryption key, GCD of E comma phi of n must be 1. That means E and phi of n must be co-prime. E and phi of n must be co-prime. We already know what is phi of n, right? Here also we can know what is phi of n. So Alice need to choose random key. So that means, what do you mean by GCD of E comma phi of n is, there must no number that divides neatly into E and into p minus 1 except for 1. That is, we know, right, it is a co-prime. Now we got the public key. Now we got the public key, we need to generate the private key. So the public key is generated with respect to the, sorry, private key is generated with respect to the public key what is chosen earlier. Now during the step 4, solve the equation to find the decryption key D. This is a very, very secret information. This should not be shared to anyone. So you can see that how it is going to be generated, that is E into D is equal to 1 mod phi of n, right? We can able to understand here E into D, it should be 1, it should be equal to 1 mod phi of n. And also E should be either 0 equal to greater than D, 0, D should be either greater than or equal to Z, or greater than less than or equal to N, less than or equal to N. So now we can able to understand here how to choose the D so that I will get N. It is purely based on multiplicative inverse. I think we can able to understand here multiplicative inverse. When I am multiplying one number with the other, when I am getting the output as 1, that means E is inverse of D, or D is inverse of E. That is multiplicative inverse of D, multiplicative inverse of E. When both are multiplicative inverse of each other, then I will get 1, otherwise I can't. So D is a unique number that is less than n, that will be that when multiplied by E, it gives you 1 mod of phi of n. So again, you can able to understand now we got the D. So what is the condition for the D is, if I am choosing a D for decryption, it must be multiplicative inverse of V with respect to phi of n. phi of n, if it is going to be give 1 when I am multiplying d with e. So, now Alice got the key d, right. So, Alice got the key d. That means, I got both the key, that is your public key as well as the private key. So, now we are coming to the conclusion of this particular part. I got both the key, which is the step 5 is explaining about publishing public key encryption is PU is equal to E comma N, where E is encryption key, N is modulus, modulus of the system. So, now whenever a user, for example, Bob need to send a message to Alice, he should know that PU, then only they can able to send. Not only Bob, any user, if they want to send a particular message, they need to get the PU. Then the sixth step is telling about the secret private decryption key. Keep secret the private decryption key. We have to keep it very, very secret. Do not share with anyone. What is that value? PR is equal to D comma N. So, from this we can able to understand the process is very, very clear. It is mentioning about the first thing I need to generate, I need to select 2 prime numbers, then I need to go for multiplying that to get N, and also I am, in addition to that, I am doing the phi of N function, and that is used for choosing the encryption key. And from the encryption key, I am deriving the decryption key. Then, once I got these 2 keys, then it is going to be used for sharing with the public key, whereas the secret key must be kept secret. So, whenever a user want to send a message, definitely they should get the public key of a person whom they want to communicate, in the case of your public encryptor system or asymmetric encryptor system. Whereas, in the symmetric encryptor system, they are going to use only 1 key which is generated. Now, we will see that how this process is going to be happening with an example. So, we know these steps already, we have discussed in the previous slide. Now, we are assuming it is not a large prime number. For understanding, we are taking very small number, small prime numbers uses for demonstration. So, P is equal to 7. Q is equal to 19. So, now Alice is choosing 2 prime numbers, 7 and 19. Now, they are going to compute N is equal to P into Q. So, N is equal to P into Q, they are getting 133. Then, immediately they want to find out the phi of N. So, phi of N is P into Q, P is 7, that is P minus 1 into Q minus 1. That is 7 minus 1 into 19 minus 1, that is 6 into 18, that is 108. Now, randomly choosing E, but the condition for randomly choosing the E is it should give GCD of E comma 108 is equal to 1. That means GCD of E comma phi of N, the phi of N value is 108. So, E comma E is equal to 5. If I am choosing any value, you can choose, but for example, we are taking 5. We can also choose some other value which can give you 1, that is GCD of that value comma 1. We can also choose some 7, like that we can able to choose. So, now I am choosing E is equal to 5. GCD of 5 comma 108, there is no common divisor between this. So, I am getting 1. So, now the E becomes the public key. E becomes the public key. Now, I am going for the decryption. For choosing decryption, already know very well that process is E into D mod of phi of N, E into mod of phi of N. So, we need to go for an iterative process. Now, we are given this is 65. Let us check the value. 65 into 5 is equal to 325. 325 mod 108 is equal to 1. So, now we can keep 65 as the private key, 65 as the private key. So, we got two keys, one is 5, another one is 65. The 5 is the public key, we can share it with anyone. 65 is the private key, should be kept secret, should not share with anyone. So, that is what it is given here, the PU is equal to 5, 133, PR is equal to 65, 133. This 133 is N, 133 is N. Already we got the N value. So, the public key is 5, 133, private key is 65, 133. Now, we work with an example where encryption and decryption from M. Suppose Alice is having these two key, Bob want to send a message, M is equal to 6. So, what Bob recovered here is PU. Assume that Bob want to send a message 6 to Alice. So, Bob want the public key of Alice. So, now Alice is ready to share the public key, not the private key. So, Bob will receive the public key, any more you can receive, even it can put in any open forum or any public website, anywhere they can enable. So, because it is not that secret, anybody can able to see that particular public key information. Now, what is happening here? We already know the encryption process, C is equal to m power e mod n, C is equal to m power e mod n, where C is the ciphertext, m is the message what exactly want to share, and E also known, N is also known to Bob. Now, Bob is computing the value, what is the value? 6 power, 6 is the message, power M, M is the public key, 6 power M, M is the public key, mod of 133, mod of 133 is 62. Now, this is the ciphertext, this is the ciphertext which Bob will send to the Alice, Bob will send to Alice. After receiving this message, Alice need to know what is exactly the message sent by Bob. So, what Alice will do is, she will take the 62, M is equal to, we know the decryption process, we will take the 62, they will go for the decryption process. In order to get the decryption, they have to use the decryption key, that is our D. So, M is equal to C power D mod N, that is 62 power, what is the D value? 65. 62 power 65 mod of 133, what is exactly we are going to get here is 6. So, now Alice got the message what exactly sent by the Bob. So, this process is explaining about how a message can be sent with the help of your public key and private key. One thing we need to keep in remember, that is public key must be shared with others, then only they can able to send the encrypted message. And also each and every user must generate the public and the private key, then only they can able to participate in the secure communication. So, this is what it is explaining of step by step, P into Q 133 minus 1 108, it got it. And now, how they are choosing, we already know generating private key, how they are generating, here they are using Euclidean's algorithm to find the GCD E comma 108. It is an iterative process where they go for, first they took E is equal to 2, they try. 2, it is not it is not obeying the what is we told and the case of your choosing of E. Now, E is equal to 5, they are trying for 3, it is not giving 1, 4, they are not giving 1, 5, it is giving 1. So, when I am getting 1, then I am ready to choose. It is not necessarily to stop with the first value, they can also proceed further. For example, 6, they can try 7, 8, 9, like that, they can keep on trying, and also they can choose randomly which one they want to get it as a public key, sorry. Now, generating the D okay, if you want to find the d such that e into d is equal to 1 mod of phi of n. So, what I am want to do here is, I know e, they are doing this process with the values for the k from this particular step. D is equal to 1 plus k into phi of n, 108 divided by e, that is 5. So, k is equal to 0, 1, 2, 3, like that they will try. At one point of time, they can able to get the whole number, that will be considered as the, here you can able to see that 21.8, we cannot keep that as a key. 43.4, it is not, you cannot keep that as a key. So, when I am getting the 65, then, so here it is the solution. We need to try the values for the key until k until an integer solution for d is found. So, now we got the private key d. So, encryption process and the decryption process, what we explained in the previous steps. So, encode the ASCII string. Suppose I want to encrypt the input message. So, secret exclamatory mark. I need to take the corresponding ASCII value, that is the ASCII, that is which is mentioning here for S is 83, E is 101, C is 99, R is 114, E is 101, like that. We have to get this particular value, ASCII value. This is the message. This process is explaining about how we can able to send the message, how we can able to send the message. So, now we can able to see that the corresponding 83 is going to be message input for the particular value. So, 83 is going to be converted into binary because it is a decimal. Okay, so, it is converted into a, it is correspond to the value of 83. This is correspond to 101, 99. Like that, we will be converting that into a, it is going to be 33. So, we got this value. After that, we will go for message input of 16 bit, how the 16 binary is going to be represented. Then this input for the message input 16 bit decimal for secret is, okay, this is the value which is going to be given as the input message. So, once we got this input message, we can able to see there is a padding in the last digit if we want to get it. And then they will go for sample of 16 bit key generation N, E, D, and how this is going to be used with the help of your message, it is going to be generated. This is how we deal with 1024 bit value. So, you can see that already in the beginning I told you N is equal to 1024, then 1024 means we can imagine how many digits of number. This start from this point to this point is one number, 9351805. This point to this point is one number. Similarly, E is chosen, then private key is from starting from 1192889 is the private key. So, this is the way how the process of communication is happening when I am using 1024 bit key for encrypting my content. So, there are two one-way functions is involved in security of RSA. One is encryption function, another one is multiplication of two prime numbers. Why it is called one-way function is, we can able to proceed in one direction, but it is very, very difficult to get back in the other direction. So, generally the encryption function is a trapdoor one-way function whose trapdoor is private key. That is, a person knowing the public key N, it is very, very difficult to get back the. Suppose an attacker want to get the message, he need to know the private key. We already know that public key is open, anyone can able to get the public key. So, if the person gets the public key and N, it is very, very difficult to get back the private key. That is what is the difficulty as factoring, where it can able to, trapdoor knowledge is believed that to be difficult as factoring, it is very, very difficult. Other thing is difficulty of determining RSA private key from public key. So, this is also another one challenging, multiplying of two prime numbers, where it is very, very difficult. By knowing the public key, it is very, very difficult to go for getting the private key. So, these two functions are involved in RSA, which keep the RSA is going to be more secure, and also it is used till date. This is one of the popular algorithm which is used in various application when we want to understand of the public key cryptosystem. So, in the summary, we are able to understand how this RSA public key cryptosystem is working, and also how the key were used for generation during the RSA algorithm, and the security features, as we mentioned, two functions. Okay, one is going to be your encryption function, and there is a multiplication of two prime numbers as a trapdoor function, which makes this RSA successful. Thank you.